He's out there with Smith. Mutombo is out there with Dominic Wilkins. And it's Bennett into the power forward position. Here's Stevenson. Here's West. Stevenson kicks it to West. Pass to Hill. Now here's Hibbert. G right out. Good job in the low post. Hibbert's got the first points in the scoreboard for Indiana.
Boy, the defense looked helpless there. I mean, he's way up every time. He's got a smaller defender.
Too much up. Oh, call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Nice work to get it inside and draw contact. Exactly. The defense determined not to allow the easy layup right there. They'll settle for making him earn the free throws.
The free throw drops for Mutombo. Is no good. And here are the Pacers now. It's West with the drive. And the dunk by West.
Yeah, just solid work on the back end of that play.
Then to right, finish hard with two hands on that stuff.
Yeah, highly efficient. Nothing extra special there. Just effective.
Now, here's Mutombo. Smith, the best to Mutombo. Here's Wilkins, and it's sent back by West. And now, pushing it up. Misses that one. He's made one and missed two this game so far. Wilkins against Georgia. Here's Pettit over West. Pettit, good.
And if you're the guy who has to guard him, it is never going to be an easy night for you.
I'm Dwayne Stevenson. It's back to Hill. That's good. And it's Stevenson with the assist. Hill's got his first 2 points of the night.
Outstanding entry pass there. He knew exactly where to go with the ball.
Smith dishes to Rivers. And Hill over. Mutombo. Hill pulls it in. And so it's Indiana with it. It's West with the drive. And the layup's good off the glass. West has got his second basket of the game.
You know, with that much of a height advantage, that's exactly what you should do. Take it straight to the rim.
To the paint, Pettit, score of the basket, his second of two attempts.
Nice way to start the evening, and his numbers getting called. Well, yeah, for good reason.
Well, you know, Greg, they can count on him to get fouls. I mean, he's getting the ball because he's very efficient when he gets it.
2 points, that one goes. Smith's got his first points in this one.
Well executed, and then you love the strong finish.
Fantastic speed on the break. Speed, foot, showing no mercy. In transition there, partner.
And guys, what's your take on the scoring breakdown for the Pacers?
Guys, right from the start, it's prepared. They're determined to establish a presence in the paint.
The other thing they've had going for them tonight is their passing. I mean, doing a nice job. Plenty of their points early on coming off assists.
One free throw is good from Hill. Trail by three. Smith kicks to Rivers. Mutombo up top. Smith against Stevenson. Nice shot by Smith. Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. And here's Stevenson. Still getting warmed up by basketball. No buckets yet on the game for him.
Yeah, just nice strip there, and then just off with the shot.
Boy, with all the contact he drew there, Greg, that would have been a heck of a bucket. He nearly got it to go.
And he's got his first free throw of the game.
Take a break. 2 shots.
So he makes them both.
Here's Smith. Pass the bunt. Here's the dish to Rivers. Screen by Smith. Rivers has it to Bennett. Loses it off the screen and lays it up and in. Bennett's got 6 points. The bucket.
Yeah, and he's connecting on a lot of his shots here, shooting a high percentage from the field, really giving his team the most.
Inside, Wilkins slams it in.
Oh, such a beautiful pass to set that one.
Yeah, the pass might have been pretty, but the finish was angry.
Well, you need both to make it special, and they pulled it off just right.
Here's George. Dominic Wilkins making his nice shot there.
Easy man to stop, but he's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
And guys, I like the fact that he chose the one-hand tomahawk slam because you get a little higher than you have one hand and one foot.
Gibson stepped in for Smith. Here's Smith. Gets to George. Back to West. Just fine to shoot. Here's Hibbert. And then Hibbert with the dunk.
And guys, that's his game. I mean, battling in the paint and cashing in on those second chance opportunities.
But cashing it hard. I mean, Brian, that's an exclamation point. Positioning on the putback.
Yeah, these defenders just look a bit overmatched, especially
And count the shot is good. He'll go to the fifth row line.
And a lot of scoring here early on. This is the type of game that
fans love to see. You're getting to the point where you assume every shot is going to go down. I mean, nobody's missing out there.
Yeah, plan to make it a switch here. Johnson's checked in. Johnson against George. To the inside. Here's Smith. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
And they repeatedly broke inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Johnson against George. Down in the low post. It goes. George has got his third bucket of the night. Against Hill. Here's Hudson. Here's Pettit on the money from 12 feet away.
Defensive rebounding, just such a crucial part of the game.
Yeah, it's finishing the defense, but if you know that, you can defend and you got to rebound and miss, and you got to get to the glass with intensity.
And I is going first quarter. Both teams really going up. Pacers out in front, up two. Second quarter. And when you consider how the Pacers are doing, guys, what do you think?
They're just very aggressive on the offensive side. Attacking the rim in this first quarter.
Here's Watson. Stevenson is out there with Watson. And Stola has never came to set. That's the five to begin the second quarter for the Pacers. He hits shot and second shot opportunity, and the bucket is good for Hibbert indeed. Hibbert's got the first points up on the board here in the second quarter for the Pacers. Feeds Dodds. Pass to Bennett. He kicks it, Dodds. Just find the shoe. And a pick comes off the rim, but it sinks right in. Watson's got his first 2 points. Stevenson outside. Here's Scola. Can't get the ball. For the Pacers, they come in off the loss to the Bulls in Chicago. Now a feed does. 16 feet away, and the rebound goes to the Pacers.
Cannot give them that much room from mid-range. They got to feel lucky. They didn't knock that one down.
Count the basket.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not being aggressive enough down low. You got to play with some physicality in the back.
Now, here's George. He's got seven. It's good.
And good passing. Setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Now, them dropping the lights is what I call it.
Yeah, that's a nice pass. I will give you that.
Yeah, he's on the run. And the basket by Stola.
Jerry, what the hell? What are you over there yelling at the TV?
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
And he's off the mark by Atlanta. Indiana leading by eight. To the paint, here's Stevenson. There's the basket and making a double-digit lead.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting in the paint and continue to score consistently.
Atlanta calls timeout. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. All the way to the final whistle.
Hey, Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows that they're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
To the ball out of bounds. Scola touched it last. The Hawks trail by 10. Johnson outside. He dishes a dodge. Johnson a screen. And then it's a bad dodge. And Leandro Barbosa gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. Dishes to Millsap. Tries to snap the cold streak, and it's 2 points on the layup.
Just a late reaction there from the defense, who is always going to finish that.
It's stolen by Johnson. Here's Maravich. He feeds to Millsap, and he gets the bucket.
And that's almost automatic anytime he can get the ball.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight. Wilkins has checked in for Atlanta. He's had some playing time, but no score yet for him. It's George on the wing. Left block shot on the way. And the basket by Stola. And the Pacers lead by 9.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
Oh, they're working the glass really fast. That's helped them take this lead.
Yep, I'm making a switch here. Kerr's checked in. Comes out the screen. Johnson. Well executed. Great rhythm. You've got to finish that.
Agree with you there, partner, because that screen really freed him up nicely, and that's a shot. And if you're a pro, you need to make that.
Hawks trail by nine. Dishes it to the jump. Nice ball movement here by Leonard. Pass to Rivers. Parries the long-range jumper. Rivers has got himself on the board with three down.
He could have forced a tough inside shot, but made a terrific kick out to find the open jumper instead.
Here's him. And so he draws the foul on the shot on trip to the line to shoot two. For Indiana, they have again missed a free throw. 5 for 5. No good on the free throw. Jaden Glass just checked in for the Pacers. Hill comes in for C.J. Watson. And he's good on the second. There's 1:38 left here in the second. Rivers kicks to Hudson. He's got a screen. Up off the screen. And he jams it with authority.
And did you see the screen that was set for him? I mean, that was how he got to the hoop.
That was the classic screen play. Won't show up in the box score, but that screen deserves an assist.
Absolutely, Kevin. I mean, that took the defender right out of the play.
Here's Rivers. Oh, here we're picking up that last basket. Offensive rebound. A nice shot by Hudson.
He's really starting to ramp it up now, getting involved in the offense here after being held without a point.
The dish to Barbosa. Takes it off the glass. Barbosa's got his first bucket of the night.
I mean, it's just fun to sit back and enjoy watching him operate. And that's what it looked like the D was doing as well. They're just sitting back and watching.
And the foul called on Paul Millsap. That's his first foul.
I think he's got to be more aggressive, stronger, getting through those screens. Can't allow shooters that kind of space to pull the trigger.
Looking at who's out there now for the Pacers. Allen's checked in for Hibbert. And Lance Stevenson subbed in for Leandro Barbosa. Here's George. Indiana again, missing. The Hawks trail by 5. Here's Wilkins, and that's going to be a travel. Twelve seconds left to play here in the half. George passes to Allen. And Stevenson kicks to George. Oh, good on the three. And we're through the first half of basketball here in what's been a good one. Pacers lead by 5. And we'll be back right after halftime for the start of the third quarter. We'll see what it is.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And an exciting first half indeed. Welcome back. I'm Murray Johnson alongside Kenny. For the Pacers, the first quarter was taking a look at the Pacers. Kenny, what do you think?
Well, Hager pounding. I mean, pounding it in. Not just taking the first three-pointer when it came across. That keeps the defense on its toes.
And Shaq, what do you see for Atlanta?
Whatever they get playing well defensively coming up, that needs to change. Can't let a team shoot for percentages out of their mind and expect to come out on top. It's on the coaches and the players to adjust.
And that's all we can do for them. As the second half begins, we get you back to Kevin Hart.
To Indianapolis, Indiana, where the famous Chase Tower stands tall above the city. It's been a back-and-forth game so far, with no ground given through the first. Third quarter starting here now. Pacers leading by 5 on the court for a battle. You got Mutombo.
He's going to put that one.
Now they're starting to rub it in. Build up a lead, and here we go, baby. It is showtime.
over there, Kevin. Such a fast shot. Quick release. Really hard to guard him. And that one's good by Stevenson. Stevenson's got his second bucket of the night.
Absolutely fearless. I mean, a nice subtle adjustment there going up against Gwen.
I could not say it any better. Showing us a real focus, taking it inside against the bigger man.
Wilkins dishes the baton. Trying to shoot. Wilkins, no good.
You must make that. Even with the defense pressure, these are shots you have to finish.
And it's Hibbert missing.
And that's superb defense. I mean, they played it well. Not easy trying to alter these shots without fouling the shooter. And that's a good job of going both.
Here's Rivers. They got it. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
Clearly a foul. I mean, they didn't give them any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you got to play without fouling.
Misses, so he splits the free throws. Pacers leading by six. Here's Stevenson, and some very quick points for him on that possession. Stevenson's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And they're beginning to just grab ballpark defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen. They're in a hurry. I think, Kevin, they're rushing things a little bit to begin that out. Nothing pretty about this 1-for-4 start.
Clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there. Earned those free throws.
Pacers have shot 6 of 7 at the line.
More aggressive inside.
Johnson drops them both.
And at the line, it's all about consistency with him. His routine, his stroke, it never wavers.
West gets the bucket.
There's PT created for a teammate. Terrific dime drop.
Outside, Merrimack. And Hibbert with the block. He's again.
A slight rebound advantage for them. One more combo in their favor. And it's all adding up.
That's one of the many areas that they've had the advantage. As a result, they've got a big lead.
Matumbo sets a screen. Here's Johnson. The shot's here on the assist.
first trip to the free throw line for him tonight. Free throw drops for Watson. Hawks free by nine. Outside, Mirage to the paint, 13 feet away. And he gets the kind bounce as that one drops in for him. Bennett's got 10 points in the game. On the way to Stevenson. West kicks to Stevenson. This one for three. And that's out of bounds. Indiana will retain possession. On defense, the Hawks. Big trail by seven. George with the stuff.
He's their go-to guy. When he shoots the ball like he has today, that's what the scoreboard usually looks like.
The Atlanta Hawks come to this one after the win against Memphis. Here's McCullough. It's rebounded by Stevenson.
I'd love to see them impose themselves a little more on the backboard. That's a great way to find confidence. Always a surefire way to get back. Something to reduce this deficit. We'll see if that's the answer. Gotta DM up better than that. I mean, when you got a smaller guy on the inside, that's dinner. Barbecue chicken. That's extra. I love that.
Man, this shooting has been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons
we're
up in this game.
Atlanta calls timeout. Checked in for the Hawks. Tries it for 19, and it's wide right. It's off the rim. Outside, George takes it to Stevenson from deep, and it's George missing. The Hawks 3-of-12 on the wing. Count it, good. Johnson's got 6 here in this quarter.
Joe Johnson showing us a beautiful stroke right there.
Feeds it to Watson. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Johnson.
And defensively, great anticipation, making a play there on the ball.
Well, the thing they did there, Greg, clogged up the passing lanes, playing them beautifully and making things hard for the opponent. That's really good defense.
Here's George. That's a basket. He is 8th from the field, 8-14.
Continuing to push the action and build this lead.
Yeah, you know, continue to pour it on. That's what they want to do right now. Doing their best to put this game out of reach and in the win column.
That one good for two. George has got 21 in the game.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, Greg, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
Here's Hudson, pass to Matumbo. And he uses the glass on the way. Matumbo's got 5.
And then that's got to happen if they want to have a chance to turn this thing around. I mean, he needs to just take the game over. I mean, it seems like he's been hesitant to pull the trigger.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Stevenson inside the three-point line. Off the left, rim it out.
Yeah, that's just poor decision making. Hey, he's got to be better.
In a brain neutral position.
That is as big a shot as you are ever going to see.
And guys, he won it. He desperately was begging for that ball and was dying to take that shot.
And as we end the third quarter, a double digit deficit will make it tough to come back. It's the Pacers up by 10. And time to step aside quickly, but we'll be back in no time with the start of the fourth quarter. Welcome back. Fourth quarter action starting up. 2K Sports, happy to have you with us.
And there's Allen. And it's stolen at the four-man position. So that's good about it for Indiana.
I'll tell you what, guys. His size really comes into play when there's a rebound battle going on. He's got an advantage in it.
And finished off by River.
Sometimes when you want something done,
you got to do it yourself. It's just changed the NBA. It's changed our society and culture at large, and it's here to stay. I just like to see people productively and fruitfully use social media. And I like to see less of the vitriol and hatred that is afforded for people to hide behind their negative comments.
Roy Hibbert's checked in for Indiana. Barbosa comes in for C.J. Watson, and a switch here also for Atlanta. Smith is checked in. Okay, let's go down to David Aldridge for.
Hey guys, well, the Hawks coach had some nerves on his team during the last time out. He said, "Do you want this game? Don't tell me about it. Show me and show your teammates. We've got to play better and we've got to play harder if we're going to come back." That's a good
one. And it's George missing. The Hawks trail by eight. Here's Wilkins. And that basket's going to count, folks. It's the world's ending call right there.
To getting the block there. You can live with those calls because you'd rather have a guy play instead of playing second. And clearly you can hear what the crowd thinks about that call.
You sure can. I mean, they erupted as soon as that whistle blew. No time between the call and the eruption.
Rivers hits to Smith. Another three for Atlanta.
Defensively, you can't back off him that much. You don't want to give up easy threes at this stage of the game.
Here's George. Doesn't go that time. So Atlanta will take it the other way.
The shooting numbers just not there yet in the quarter. Oh, great effort there. That's how you defend the paint.
Exactly. Can't play it any better than that, Greg.
And then he's been way off the mark this quarter. It's been ugly.
Hawks passing it around. Rivers a screen on George. Six on the shot clock. Wilkins passes the ball for the score, and it's Bennett missing. Pacers leading by five. It's Leandro Barbosa on the line. The three from George gets it to go from beyond the arc. George has got 13 points here in the second half alone. Wilkins with the ball. By George. There's the feed to Scola. Back to Barbosa. Hibbert in the high post. And then George with the jam.
Oh, that's an old fashioned rim wrap.
Just a remarkable jam. These fans' jaws are on the ground right now.
Platinum level highlight reel material. That is showtime stuff there.
Swing by Smith. And the officials will call the illegal
screen. When he set that screen, you don't argue that he was set, but I really didn't think so.
subbed in for Leandro Barbosa. Atlanta calls timeout. They're trailing by 12. A minute 50 left to play here in the fourth. And now let's present our Jordan player of the game, Paul George.
And guys, he's been about as close to perfection as you can be. The intensity he's played with has been amazing. Just no let up. And as fired up as he's been, he's never let his emotions get out of control.
This was a big game for him. There's no denying that. Coming off a bunch of losses in a row, they turned to him to break the streak, and he delivered in a big way. Left in the game. The pass to Mutombo. Vicious to Wilkins. Mutombo kicks to Rivers. Pass to Benninger. It's going to be out of bounds. The Pacers will take it. They can take their time on this possession.
Continues to grow. They are just piling it on now.
Yeah, it looks too easy for them. Almost looks too easy for them, I should say, Greg. I mean, their chemistry really, really at a high level.
And league expansion is something that simply won't leave the conversation in the NBA right now, Clark. Do you think that the NBA adding another team or two is inevitable?
I don't think it's inevitable. As a matter of fact, I think we're at a good number where we are, Kevin. It's still the best league in the world, and I think you could dilute that a bit if you added teams. So I'm fine with where we are.
Hill, there's your favorite. And good. That thing is that time is full.
And how much longer are they going to keep that foot on the accelerator?
As long as required, Greg. I mean, you can tell. You're going to kick this thing to bed.
You're not sure what that was about. I mean, talk about a brain cramp.
Yeah, completely a brain fade. I don't know where that came from. Just lost sense of time and the situation.
Matching up on the changes now for Indiana. LaVoy Allen's checked in for Hickens. Stola comes in for West. Leandro Barbosa checked in for George. And it's Watson in for George Hill. And now they decide to foul intentionally. He throw good Maravich. Maravich hits them both. 30 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Austin gets to Barbosa. They set the screen. Allen. Contained shot. Score on the left.